I've made a copy of ODB33, and I'm calling this one ODB34 Relationships. We're picking up from where we left off in our last video, and I'm going to open up our ODB33 subform. With this form, I can view our employees and their phone numbers, and it works well. We made our connection between the two tables by matching up the employee IDs on both tables. Looking at our employee numbers, we've got 0, 2, 4, 5, 6. From this form, we're able to update any field on the screen. Let's go back to 2. What happens if we change our employee ID up here to the number 3? I'm going to save it. Go to the next record. And when I go back, we see 3. We don't have any phone numbers. If I change this back to 2, save it, click off it, and then back on, we were 2-2, and we have the phone numbers back. What happened was it did not update the employee ID on the phone number table. This would also be a problem if we deleted an employee off our employee table. The information would remain on the employee phone number table, and we don't want that. What we want to do to avoid that is to create a relationship. Or to be more specific, we want to set up a relationship with constraints. I'm going to close our form and open up the Relationships window, going to Tools, Relationships. When the Relationships window opens up, we have a pop-up that opens up as well, with the two tables in it, just like we did in the Query window. I will add in both tables and close the Add Tables pop-up. If we need to get that dialog box back, we can click on the Add Tables button or go into Insert, Add Tables. We want to add a relationship from the employee ID on the employees table to the employee ID on the employee phone number table. There are a couple of ways we can do that. One way is to click on the New Relationship button. I'm going to close that. Another way is to click on the employee ID from the phone number table and drag it over and place it right on top of the employee ID on the employees table. We see it draws a line creating a relationship, and we're calling this a one-to-many relationship. The one because our employee ID has to be unique on the employee ID table. That's our primary key on the employee table and will be unique for every record. Over on our employee phone number table, we can have many employee IDs. We can have one phone number, we can have two or more phone numbers, or zero phone numbers. So we say this is the many side of the relationship. This is also known as the primary key and the foreign key. So the many is the foreign key and the one is the primary key. I'm going to click on the line, right click, and delete this relationship. Now I'm going to drag it from the employees table to the employee phone number table. This brings up that relations pop-up box that we saw a few minutes ago. It also put in employee ID. If that's not the field we want, click that drop down and we can change it to any field on the table. Down below, we have something called update options and delete options. This is for the relationship. This does not mean update options for the employee phone and delete for the employees table. They're both from the primary key to the foreign key. So the update option saying, if we update the primary key, what do we want to do? Our current value is no action. We've already seen what no action can do, and that's nothing. That leaves the key as it is. We decided we did not want that, so I'm going to change this to update cascade. That means if I update my primary key, it will automatically cascade the update to my foreign key. Or when I changed my employee ID to 3, it will change all the employee IDs on the phone number table from 2 to 3. Our other option is delete. Right now, no action means it will leave the records out there on the table. We want it to delete off all the phone number records for that employee ID, so I'm going to set delete cascade and click OK. So now we've set our relationship here, but we've also given it some constraints. I'm going to delete this relationship for a moment by right-clicking on the line and then deleting. Going into Tables, Employee Phone. We know that we don't have an employee ID of 1, so I'm going to go down to the bottom and insert an employee ID of 1. We'll give them a phone number. And a note of, this record does not have a matching employee ID. Saving and closing. Now, when I go back to my relations window, if I drag from the employee phone number table to the employee table, we get an error right away. If I drag from the employee table to the employee phone number table, we get our relationships window. If I click OK, it can create a relationship, but notice there's no one or many on either side. When we created our subform, I mentioned that LibreOffice Base didn't know of any relationships. It will recognize this as a relationship, but this is more or less the same thing we did when we assigned the manual join fields. I'm going to right-click on the line and edit this. Now if I try and do an update cascade and delete cascade, when I click OK, I get that error again. Integrity constraint violation. What's happening here is we have a foreign key without a primary key. That's basically the problem. So it can't assign this. We know that it's the record that I just added, this record number 1. If you're doing this on your own, it may be difficult to find those records. In future tutorials, we're going to look at ways to do SQL to help us find those records that don't match up. I'm going to delete this off, close the table, and create a relationship again. Now we're back. We've got our one-to-many. It will update cascade and delete cascade. I'm going to save the relationship, close the window. Now let's go back to forms, open up that subform. When I go to record number 2 and change this to record number 3, and change this to record number 3, update. When I come back, now all the records on the employee phone number table were updated to number 3. If I delete this record number 0, clicking the delete record button, we would need to look at our table. But we can see that the records number 0 are now gone from our employee phone number table. I will save this database, and we're done.